stop me now. Don't stop me, 'cause I'm having a good time, having a good time.
I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity.
In many ways, the story of our firm and our practice was in the beginning kind of synonymous with Scott's story. Many people don't know and just assume he's been doing estate planning for 30 years, but you know, he was previously a corporate and securities lawyer and then ultimately in-house counsel. Started with what he always calls a small New York law firm of Skadden Arps. And that job took him to DC and New York. It took him over to Asia and the former Soviet Union, getting admitted to the bar in Paris and living and working in Brussels for a number of years. Ultimately before coming back to Boston. And I remember, over 10 years ago, interviewing for his job with this firm, not knowing Scott, not knowing the firm, and thinking to myself, this guy has been at the center of all these important inflection points, some of which are greater world history, some of which are just, you know, the higher tiers of law practice. And I remember thinking, you know, this guy's kind of like the Forrest Gump of law practice, just, you know, of course, with more intention and without the bumbling.
You know, I first met Scott when I first began networking in Greater Boston's LGBTQ+ community about 10 years ago, and quickly realized that he is a leader in that community, was then, is now, and at the time, as an extension of his practice and his knowledge, really focused on the difference in tax treatment between married gay couples at the state level and the federal level. And really, because of Scott and his knowledge of that issue, led us to adopt a stipend here at Eastern to cover that tax difference for our employees until finally and thankfully gay marriage was made legal at the federal level, eliminating that tax discrepancy.
So I first met Scott in 2003 when we both became part of the leadership team for the Board of Directors of Mass Equality at the point that we were fighting to have Massachusetts become the first state in the nation to legally recognize marriage for same-sex couples. He had a terrific ability to stand firm despite the shifting sands, to be analytic, and also really to read between the lines. He could hear not just the words that were being said, but the words that people meant in between.
But when you work with Scott, you are truly heard. And you literally start out with a blank piece of paper, and he takes the time to understand what's important to you and your family and what you want to accomplish, both in the near term as well as in the future, and encourages you to think of your estate plan as a tool or a means by which to accomplish that.
I had been interviewing a good amount, you know, all around town. And I truthfully don't remember the specifics of my interview with Scott and exactly what we talked about, but I do really remember the experience and arriving at the firm and feeling really welcomed into this, you know, warm and inviting space, which was in stark contrast to many of the other offices I had been in that just had a different feel and were, you know, less personal and a little colder. So I was almost at ease from the moment that I walked in the door. And then I, you know, sat down with Scott and we began really just having a conversation. And I felt this ability to be really open and honest with him, even though I had just met him. And he has this ability to really put people at ease and have these types of conversations where you can talk about things that, you know, aren't maybe so easy to talk about. And feel comfortable doing that.
It has been such a pleasure to get to know Scott Squillace as we have worked together on the board of the Boston Foundation. There is so many wonderful things about Scott, but one amazing thing I'm always so impressed with, that whenever we're faced with a challenge or an opportunity, Scott seems to find aspects of the issue that somehow I've missed or we've missed. And so often I turn to Scott during the most complicated issues to get his wisdom and advice. I really respect that about him. And even when it's an opinion that he has, it's different than mine or someone else's, somehow he's able to communicate that in such a constructive and warm way that I kind of think he took my opinion, whereas actually I find out that I took his opinion. Scott Squillace always takes the time to get to know people, so respectful, and it's been such a pleasure for me to get to know Scott, both professionally and personally. I count Scott a friend.
Well, you know, Scott is very warm and engaging, just fun to be around, but the consummate professional. When he is working, whether it be with his clients, which are sometimes mutual clients of Eastern and his firm, and certainly here in the boardroom, Scott is all business. He's well prepared, he knows the facts, he knows the details, sometimes even better than we do who are in the business. And so he adds a lot of value to our perspective along the way.
Scott is a member of our board of directors, chairs the development committee, and co-founded 10 years ago the Equality Fund. The Equality Fund is an endowed fund built mainly with legacy bequest intentions for the care and support of the LGBTQ community. The Equality Fund at the Boston Foundation will be one of many signature legacies of Scott's work. Scott has been a fierce champion of gay rights, gay marriage, and progressive causes in his personal life. He has built his practice on the care and advocacy for his clients. Magic happens when these two worlds coincide.
When I think about Scott's career as an estate planning attorney, it's hard to imagine a better set of skills. He is analytic and able to understand the tax issues and the legal ramifications of people's decisions, but in some ways more to the point, he also understands the sometimes difficult but unspoken issues that many of us bring to mortality and also to the question of how we'll be remembered after we pass. And so it's hard to imagine somebody better than Scott to deal with those issues for his clients.
Scott not only represents me, but he represents two other generations in my family, and this has evolved over time. So he represents my 91-year-old mother and takes great care of her, and he also represent my children. So I think this is just exemplary of how Scott is multifaceted in terms of his approach to the law.
When we first were introduced in 2009, I was working for another company, and he had posted looking to hire a position, someone to help him with research, writing a book. And that was really the foundation of our relationship together. As many of you know, it eventually came out, and you've got copies of your own. And in the interim, I left my other job and sort of volunteered to spend more time at the firm in the early days. And that, I think, has been one of the building blocks and really sort of cornerstones of the trusted relationship that we've built over the years.
So I'm sitting here all these years later, having recently been promoted to partner, with a true appreciation for that experience and his leadership and mentorship over the years. And that's something that's really important to him. There's, you know, the idea that as a self-governing profession, lawyers really have a responsibility to kind of raise the next generation of lawyers, which is something that he takes to heart and really dedicates himself to, you know, within the firm. And I think, you know, more broadly within the advisory community as well.
In addition to the terrific skills that he brings to his professional life, Scott is also a great dinner companion and terrific fun to spend time with. We've enjoyed many a dinner and many a glass of wine together, and I look forward to doing that for many years to come.
Estate planning can be scary, it can be intimidating, and Scott makes it approachable and accessible, and you feel like you're in charge and control, and I think those are very important things. And again, perhaps unique about his practice.
There's a mentality here that if we're not taking care of each other, then we won't be able to take care of our clients. And I think those deep personal relationships are what make this practice so rewarding.
When you become a client of Scott's, you are truly part of a community, family, community, however you want to think about it.
Car, passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go.
bar.